The objective of our lesson are listed below. At the end of this lesson, students should be able to identify the basis. The basis and indices of a number in form of a raised to the power of n. Students should be able to state number in index notation, numbers in index notations. And the last one, students should be able to state the laws of indices. So we start with the first one, identifying the basis and indices of a number. When we have a number in the form of a raised to the power of n, this number, the a in this form, the a is what we refer to as the base of the number, while the n is what we refer to as the power or the index of the number. So for example, if we have 3 raised to the power of 5, the 3 in this case represent the base of that number, while the 5 represents the power or index of the number. So indices is a plural of index. So what is the law of indices? So the indices here is a plural of this. So we'll go to the second objective of the lesson, which is to state number in index notation. For example, when we have a number in form of 3 raised to the power of 2, this number can be 3 raised to the power of 2. So this is like base 3 to the power of 2, or to the index of 2. This is the same thing as, this is the same thing as 3 times 3. If you have number in form of 3 raised to the power of 3, this is the same thing as 3 times 3 times 3. Number, if you have 3 raised to the power of 2 times 3 raised to the power of 4, this is the same thing as 3 raised to the power of 2 is the same thing as 3 times 3. Then we have times 3 raised to the power of 4, that is 3 multiplied 3 in 4 places. That is 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. So a number in form of, let me make more example, 5 raised to the power of 3 is the same thing as 5 in 3, multiplying in 3 places, that is 5 times 5 times 5. 10 in 4 places is the same thing as 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. So that is what we mean by expressing number in index notation. So we'll go to the first law of indices states that when we have it is called multiplication law, in which the indices are added in the multiplication law. Indices are added in this case. For example, if you have a raised to the power of n times a raised to the power of n, where m and n are integers, are positive integers, and a is not equals to zero, that is a is number above zero, like 1, 2 and so on and so forth. So if you have a number in this form, this is actually equals to a raised to the power of m plus n. This equation here is actually equals to this. That is, we pick one of the two bases. When the bases are the same, you can see that the two bases are the same. We have a, we have a, but the integers, so we, in this case, we just pick one of the bases and add the index, the indices of the two numbers. For example, if we have, let's do some example 1. If we have 3 raised to the power of 2 times e raised to the power of 4. In this case, we can see that the bases are the same. That is, we have 3 here, we have 3 here, and we have multiplication in between them. So in this case, this is just simply equals to picking one of the bases, which is 3, and adding the powers together, that is 2 plus 4. And this is going to give us 3 raised to the power of 6. If you use a long method to do this, as in using our index notation, this is the same thing as 3 raised to the power of 2 is the same thing as 3 times 3. Then times 3 raised to the power of 4. So we have 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. Putting this together, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the same thing as 3 raised to the power of 6. Example 2. If you have 10 raised to the power of 4 times 10 raised to the power of 3. This is 10 raised to the power of 4. You can see that the bases are the same. We pick one of the bases, then we add the exponents, the indices, that is 4 plus 3, and this is going to give us 10 raised to the power of 7. We can equally use the long method to arrive at this. The third example, I like making several examples. The third example, we have 5y times 4y raised to the power of 3. In this case, we can see that the 4 and the 5 are not the same, so we cannot pick 4 and 5 in this case. They are not the same, but the y and y are the same. So we just multiply the 4 and 5, we multiply them out like normal multiplication. So this is just 4 times 5, and that is going to give us 20. Then, but the y and the y here, they are the same, so we pick one of them, because the y, we have y times y raised to the power of 3. So we pick one of the y, and we have y, this is the same thing as y raised to the power of 1. We know that anything raised to the power of, for example, we have 5 raised to the power of 1 is the same thing as 5. That is 5 to the power of 1 is the same thing as 5. So we have 1 here. So this is going to be 1 plus 3. That is, we have 1 plus 3. And this is going to give us 20y raised to the power of 4. Let's do one more example. We have example 4. Example 4 says we should find 5y raised to the power of 2 times 4y raised to the power of 0 times 2y raised to the power of minus 2. So if you look at the numbers are not the same. 5, 4, 2, they are not the same. So we just multiply the number out. We multiply the number, but we can see that the y's are the same. So we can still apply the law here for the y's. So we multiply 4 times 5, that will give us 20. 20 times 2 is going to give us 40. But the y's are the same. So we pick the y, we pick one y, then we add their exponents together. That is 2 plus 0 plus minus 2. So this is going to give us 2 plus 0 plus minus 2. So this is going to give us 40y, 2 plus 0, that's going to give us 2, minus times, plus times minus is going to be, so this is going to be 2 minus 2, because this is going to give us minus. So this is going to give us 40y raised to the power of 0. So we are still going to get to something like this. Anything raised to the power of, this is the same thing as 40, this is the same thing as 40. Because any number raised to the power of 0 is always equals to 1.